has to be eliminated very early in the event. Secret IG, game three. Is your body ready?
I'm so excited, especially because of this draft. There's a clear dichotomy in the draft.
That was like the least excited.
What do you want me to say to that? I'm incredibly excited.
I want to hear your March roar right now.
The teams is going to get eliminated. I like both teams. Juan kind of looks like me. Arteezy is a good friend. Like, what do you want from me?
That was what I wanted.
I'm going to be more sad because this is in the finals. It means somebody's going to go home early. It's incredibly disappointing, and that's the thing that we never talk about, but there's a clear-cut strategy between both teams.
Oh, look at this. It's Ward Wars off the bat. Luo's in position. Both players TPing down. The Courier's going to start marching back from that bottom lane. Puppy actually deployed it after the TP. Rather unusual way to get it out there. But the Sentry Ward does get plonked down in the creep camp. Didn't actually D-Ward Puppy. Thought Luo might try for that. He's going to block off two camps. And so they discussed the possibility of a support Shadow Shaman, a solo mid Shadow Shaman Blitz, but in the end, it is going to be a support for Puppy. Do you prefer that here? What's the thinking with how you decide to put him in the support role?
I think part of it was, the Shadow Shaman pick itself was just in response to the fact that they picked a Storm Spirit. Mm-hmm. You can't just let that hero get free reign. The other strategy is to just pressure him nonstop, but we've seen that fail time and time again. We saw it yesterday with, I think it was actually the Secret Ehome game, right, where they decided they would brute force push, but eventually the Storm Spirit, if he has no natural counters on the enemy team, he just absolutely destroys you. And I think this game, they were like, okay, we need a hero that can accomplish both. We need a hero that can push and can also have some form of lockdown disable. So we have a contingency plan. In case the storm gets out of control, then we have a way to deal with
it. It's happening again. The early skirmish is coming out. They already popped the chili touch. The stun from S4, it's a complete miss. And with that, they may just have to give up this rune. So many ranged heroes and so much level one damage. Nobody wants the bottom bounty rune, though. Literally not a single hero even close to it.
That's a burning SF mid. I haven't seen that in, I don't know when the last time I've seen that.
It's very rare. Like, normally you'd even expect him to be on the storm, but just because it would take, it's better in a safe
ward.
Lane.
That's so unlucky. Kuro placed that sentry just outside of range. That was like the bare minimum.
Tough start there for him. But Burning also not having a sentry in the mid lane. Chuan is going to bring one in. He's also the salve bearer here. And they'll pop it down just in time to try and turn a Kuro. There are three raises here. Just one for now. That will drive Kuro back. And let's see if S4 gets any kind of sentry of his own. Nothing on Kuro. So they are going to have the vision advantage here, at least until the courier moves in, and it's only ferrying out a salve for now. This will protect Burning, so he should have an easier go of it against the Bounty Hunter pressure early on, but not so easy against the denies of S4.
Yeah, and Burning right now, he did get the Bounty Rune, so he should be okay in this lane, and with the Sentry mid, I think that Kuro should just skip out on trying to go there and just hope that S4 can go for a solo kill or something of that nature.
Look how deep this is. Chuan's going back to the tier 3s, and they're not even bringing the Kuro near this. He's going to body walk out a sentry, just the most defensive possible play, and guess who's there? Right.
Kuro's actually just waiting.
I'd rather have a couple chops at you if I can't get the courier.
I mean, we talked about
it. Now Chuan's going to go north. He's got to run all the way
is
around.
Is he just running around?
He's just so afraid of this bounty hunter.
Kuro's just matching his steps right now. He's just making sure that Chuan can't deliver that set of sentries.
They're going on top at the same moment. Zai taking a lot of punishment from that chilling touch. But he is getting his levels here so far. No reliable stuns early on. He's already level 3. And taking a look at the IG offlane, Luo, 3 and change. So both offlaners getting a lot here as the game gets underway. And the man who's been shut down, you mentioned the just barely missed D-Ward there. Blitz also looking towards the Radiant Pokemon. That D-Ward also missed, or at least not the Sentry Ward removed just yet. It looks like they're in range of each other, but I guess he just hasn't seen it. Chuan's going to walk by his own sentry, and Kuro will be scouted out. He grabs the bounty rune, and meanwhile, they grab an invis on Luo, who's already moving towards the mid lane. S4 doesn't have any detection. It could be another downside, but the ping starts coming out. He gets back to the safety of the high ground. If they can just cog him towards the raises, this could be your first blood. Early on, the creep scores even, so it feels like that first kill may be what opens up the game. But again, Kuro's movement's being scouted. This is a total difference maker compared to the way the previous game began, where he just kept on catching them off guard.
Yeah, he does have the support of a Darkseer, so they can get aggressive.
They've got a point and pull here on Zai. He's dangerously close to being killed off. In fact, he looks like he may be the first blood. The pull perfectly timed. Zai, chilling touch coming out the cast. They got him! IG from range, get it done. And Secret just not getting the openings that Kuro found in the previous game. No courier snipe, not able to move around and really pressure the lanes. They are slowing down the Shadow Fiend of Burning a bit. And there are no stacks current. Well, there's a single medium camp stack here. There's no huge stacks yet. But so far, it is a lead for IG in terms of the momentum.
What hurts them so much right now is that Kuro's still only level 2, or level 1, so he doesn't have that level 2 where he would be able to get Janata and possibly get a kill on Faith right there with the help of the level 2 Ion Shell. But because he's level 1 right now, it's hard for him to just roam. The time has passed where he can camp that mid lane, snipe that courier, because it is upgraded at this point, so he needs to grab a level 2 and just try to make something happen on one of the two supports. Like, those are really squishy supports right now. It's a Witch Doctor and an Ancient Apparition, and those are heroes that are really susceptible to being pretty much 3-shot and then chased down by the Bounty Hunter, but I mean, Secret need a better laning start than this, because if you look at IG's lineup, this is built for the late game. This is meant for Ferrari to be able to go into the late game and have no natural counters. The Shadow Shaman is good in the beginning, but once he decides to get a BKB, it's going to be incredibly hard for him to keep up. And if you notice, IG, they have all the tools in the world to be able to go late game. They've got a Clockwork who can just spam Rocket. You've got Faith with that Ancient Apparition Ice Blast. We've seen that combination before and how it can extend the game, and it's really difficult.
Oh, Kuro, in danger of getting caged in here. There is a pack of dust on Chuan, but he didn't actually see him in time. They had the sentry in the neighborhood. It's going to wear off soon, but in good news for Secret, the late game advantage, be that as it may, right now Secret are winning the lanes when it comes to CS. You look at their cores, every single one at 20 or above. Meanwhile, the offlane Clockwork for IG Luo getting absolutely nothing, just forced to sit back, and this is the strength of the Luna pick. We've talked about it a few times. Not only did she push, but she's really a lane dominator, especially if it's a solo offlane and you've got a range support backing you up. So Secret are pulling ahead here numerically, but they're just not finding the explosive start from game number 2.
Yeah, but they don't really need that because, I mean, what they're really waiting for is their Shadow Shaman to get some levels and for them to get a few levels on their Bounty Hunter as well. Like, they're not going to go for any sort of 5-man in the early game. It's just about controlled aggression and making sure that IG don't snowball in these lanes. Like, the fact that Ferrari is being pressured so hard by this Darkseer makes it so much easier for Secret to transition.
And Storm Spirit is going to be constantly forced back behind his tower, and I guess looking at IG, the other side of this is they really wanted the fast level 6. Once that comes online, together with the hookshot and the zip, we saw this yesterday from Vici Gaming, that even if you have a more of a late game oriented carry like a Spectre that doesn't bring a lot to the early team fights, the combo is just so scary. So although they fall behind, they are getting their levels on that particular support. The Witch Doctor of Tuan, not so much, but it feels like because of the nature of the draft, it's the AA whose levels matter more.
Yeah, they just need to be able to stall out this game and delay, because Secret, once they get level 6 on their Shadow Shaman, you have to anticipate every single time that's going to be a tower down for IG, but I mean, IG just have to hold this current pace, try to just keep up in the farm, and I mean, Bernie can just keep rotating between the jungle and build himself up.
In one sense, Secret do get a laning advantage here, as the offlane is fully abandoned now by the Clockwork of Luo. He's moved on towards mid. Rocket is going to scout S4. He's deep behind enemy lines. Nobody there to cut him off. And that is going to discourage him from moving in, and it keeps burning safe. He's level 7. Well, Laguna Blaine was online, and that is enough for a potential kill, but Burning will clear out a stack, and it looks like they want to just keep on giving this mid lane to Chuan support. Let him catch up in experience, and this is a team that uses the jungle pretty well with their cores if they're given that opportunity.
I actually think it's a little bit more important than that they give this Clockwork a few levels, because he has no farm at all right now.
Chuan is being surrounded.
S4 is going to push out this wave right now. Maybe they go for the dive. Okay, so he's going to just cut the wave as fast as he can.
There's three TPs on IG.
Yeah, he's sandwiching him though, and Chuan has to start running right now, because by the time he actually realizes this, he pops the dust.
Oh, the instincts! Chuan, they kick in, and he's just going to back. But that may free up the tower. No, Bernie rotates in. The DD's on S4. A blind stun here is almost enough for a kill in and of itself. But it's tough to land that without a setup.
It's okay though, as S4's trying to rotate around. They really want to be able to get at least one kill out of this, but I mean, Chuan's just outmaneuvering them, but S4 sees him with this ward.
Storm has a TP though. Gotta be careful about this knife, and Faith is closing in on level 6. Couple waves to go. The time to act is now for Secret, or you're fighting into the full team fight. Hook also almost online. In fact, they're going to smoke and they walk away down towards the bottom rune where Arteezy's raiding. He has Eclipse. Will Tron be fast enough? Can they chain stun him? Out comes the Eclipse. Burning's tanking all of it, and he will end up going down. Arteezy looking for the double kill. Tron forced back. That was not the opportunity that they were hoping for.
Oh, Arteezy
has another Lucent Beam. The fog is not there, and a golden beam comes down to mark the demise of Tron. And with that, it may be the demise of a crucial mid tier one tower. No Glyph. Four heroes in mid, Secret are going to get so much map control out of this one. And there's also a dive happening top for Zai. He's level 7, he's working on Faith, trying to slowly work onto him with a double Ion Shell going his way. And Faith's not level 6 yet. The surge out, creep Ion Shell, where we're off. In fact, he gets trapped under the tower in a long storm zip. 430, a bit off the mark, but now he's got Chilling Touch. Surge, cooling down for 3 seconds. This should be a kill in the end. They'll get the exchange. Faith hits level 6. He's almost dead. Has no mana for a TP. 45 seconds. He's going to Clarity run into the trees. Give me mana. Give me mana. He should get out.
Yeah, and Arteezy's rotating.
Barely.
Too.
Barely. Barely. But he does.
They're going to take this tower. And at the same time, IG were executing their strat pretty flawlessly. Except for that bottom rune fight, Arteezy picks up 2 by himself, and that's so huge.
That's the Luna dream right there.
You run into a Shadow Fiend that's level 8, you get all of that experience, you slow down his farm, and at the same time, in Burning, I don't think he should have chanced that. I think what he was hoping for was all of the Lucent Beams hit the Witch Doctor, he sacrifices him, but even if you go for the triple raise there, I don't think you can kill him.
Yeah, because Arteezy went for the build-up we saw last time around. Just cheap, cost-effective items, the Reign of Aquila, early Bracer, Treads, and Magic Wand, and it gives you a huge HP pool into the 4 digits, so maybe with a triple raise and a couple auto-techs, he could just get the job done. And admittedly, a lot of the Lucent Beams hit Burning there. Tron was not in range initially, so perhaps just that split second of communication was not quick enough to react in time. But now they've got their ultimate splits. They have the Ice Blast, IG have the hook shot as well, and they are on the move. They've even got a ward here off in the Radiant Jungle, but there's just no vision on the actual heroes. The entirety of the Secret lineup is missing. This gives 430 pause, and it also means the smoke gank is looking to be a bit of a long shot.
And this is what IG was waiting for. They got level 6 on their Ancient Apparition, and even without a lot of farm on that Clockwork, that level 6 Ancient Apparition, he's able to pretty much kill just between that duo. I think they can even snipe Arteezy if they get lucky, if he's completely alone, but they're just going to give this tower up. I think that Secret know for sure that IG are down here. There's no reason to chance this fight right now without vision.
Do they want to try and go top with an Ice Blast, potentially? That's the thing to keep in mind with IG is they've got Faith all the way bottom, so anyone who shows the top could potentially be a go. But if they go on this, they're going into 4. Not sure 430 realizes, but everybody's still missing. They only show Zai top lane. This has to be suspicious for IG. Now, Kuroki still in Viz, not hitting creeps just yet. Maybe he wants to attract a little attention, and they've already got the wraparound going. Shadow Shaman Ward's not yet online. 430 in danger, about to be hexed. Oh, he doesn't get it off in time. No jump out, no escape. 430 down. The trade for IG will be pressure bottom, but they're giving up the kill as well as the tower. It's a tier 2 being worked upon, but already the rotation. S4 is going to TP, and he pings himself. Looks like he's calling for backup. Luo hides in the trees. He's got the hook at the ready. Who's he going to connect on to start this fight? Does he go in? He does onto Zai immediately off the bat. The Ice Blast follow-up ends him off the bat, but they trade. They lose the Clockwork to the Laguna Blade, so a 1-for-1 and a 2-for-1 around the map. And this is with Arteezy not joining the fight. He's pushing the top lane, forces out the Glyph. They never got the tier 2. Secret. Now forcing the enemy out of their jungle in the end. Kuroki going to scout them out. He is still not level 6, though, so no track golden play just yet.
Some concern for IG right now is that their Storm isn't getting a lot of farm, and at the same time, they go for the gank on him. He hasn't really had a solo kill. This isn't the amount of farm that you want on your safe lane Storm. I think at this point, you would want another point, like a point booster on top of what you already have. So this is definitely an under-farmed Storm Spirit, and at the same time, IG did so much damage to that bottom tower that I kind of think that trade was worth it. Because Arteezy, yes, he was by himself at top, but he barely got any damage at that top tower, and so
Speaking of Arteezy, IG do not want to mess with him right now.
I mean, they found out what happened the first time around. You remember that stuff, LD.
It really eats away at you.
That's a fully completed mech now on IG, on that Shadow Fiend, and I think this is going to mean go time for them, or at the very least, they can defend fights. Because they know that they don't have the levels on Secret to really contest this.
Speaking of go time, Secret are also moving. This is right before they get track, though. So even if they get kills, they won't have the bonus gold. But they may start the fight off onto Burning. He gets Hex. He won't be able to mech. The hook comes through. He gets it off. Now the turn. Ice Blast on the three. They explode. They simply melt before the combo. Kuro's forced back. The wards got dropped. They'll be farmed up. It was the hook from Luo. It set it up. It saves Burning. It gets the triple. And it puts IG back on even footing. Blitz, a complete swing of all the graphs, and the momentum utterly blunted.
I mean, Secret didn't expect that type of five-man play by IG. S4 wasn't even in position quite yet. He was trying to get his Yule Scepter at that bottom lane. They probably are going to... No, he gets so unlucky with that cast.
Oh, that's not going to bounce. Tuan in danger now. Just an auto attack would get it done, but the heal keeps him alive. That and the early Urn pickup.
Oh, that was so
barely
unlucky.
Enough. Just barely.
The coconut bounces on S4 at the end again.
Just trolling him.
Everything that could be going wrong for Seeker right now is...
They have track gold. Even if things are going wrong, you always have the potential for a big swing. Right now, they don't have vision, though. That is a bit of concern.
I mean, the main problem, though, is that the storm is eventually going to snowball LD. He's going to start to get some items, and IG, they can lock this game up in the late game.
They have a Yules. They hook. And they are going to look to go, but it's on the creep. Not quite ideal. Ice Blast coming through on Arteezy, forcing him back. He doesn't have the Eclipse, and they know it. This is time to strike for Secret. They move back in onto Luo. Cox come out, and he ends up getting pulled out of them by the back of Zai, but he's up on the high ground, protected by his low ground friends. He will TP out. Great escape. Almost a sensational play from Zai, but couldn't quite find the follow-up.
I think that was a little bit of a miscommunication error, because I think S4 should have just gone for the Yules play and lifted him up in the air to guarantee the fact that they get the stun. Luo was so far away from the rest of his team, he had already used his cogs and his hook. That should have been the play right there, but good play by IG, rotating out. And what I'm talking about right now, though, is that this Storm just continues to farm during all of this. You ganked him up early, but at the same time, Shadow Shaman as a support, he needs a lot to be able to deal with that Storm Spirit.
And you've got Burning. Room. Burning is the leader in net worth. A level 11, despite the early pressure, he's 30 CS up on Arteezy's Luna. It's kind of a flip-flop from the last game, where it's the one position for IG getting the early advantage. And maybe this is where we see the Burning Shadow Fiend make a little more sense. It's less of the tempo controller, and sure, he normally doesn't go mid, but he got the help from Tron early, and it's a hero that can really flash farm if given the space.
And Ferrari clears the ward out of their jungle, and he does have a regen popped, and this means that they are going to go for the smoke. I think this is them intercepting their own jungle, just because they know that a lot of Secret heroes are at top. And
well, they're mobilizing. The smoke's going to break. Instant dust on Kuro. Hookshot not even needed. He's just going to walk in through the slow. Pull him back. No chance. IG, five hero smoke in the end, and Bernie was kind of farming top. They only get a bounty hunter, but it's another kill. And it also just blunts any offensive from Secret, who are not driving IG back towards their side of the map the way that they were in game two.
I think this is going to mean that Arteezy has to go for the BKB first. If the early game had gone slightly better, he could have gone for that same greedy build.
That Dominator, Sanjin Yasha type build.
Yeah, exactly. But with how this game's gone, he has to go for the BKB, and that means that Secret are committed to the late game. They have to start winning fights sooner than later. Their cores aren't getting the amount of farm that they want. They don't even have a mech completed yet on Zai. And Kuro just hit his level 6, they have to start getting some track kills. This is a 0-1-0 bounty hunter who's effectively
Yules,
zero impact.
Yules, but S4 is getting nuked from the high ground. They heal and mech way too much. He's not even close to getting the kill there. Doesn't cost them a huge cooldown, but it just more feels... It's frustrating for Secret. Last game, the kills were easy. They had the Zeus ult, they had so much burst damage, and IG were just squishy. But this time around, they've got the urn already that's come out on the Witch Doctor, and Faith picking up a cloak. So these supports are not the one-shot kills that they were in game number two.
Yeah, and the Shadow Shaman is a counter to the Storm Spirit with the disables that you have, but at the same time, it only matters if you have a Blink Dagger. If the Storm decides to go in on you and there's a BKB SF, there's not a whole lot that you can do to initiate or even get on top of the Storm, because he can just roll on top of you. You're a 900 HP hero with barely any armor.
How much pressure do you think Secret are under in terms of the overall strategy? You've said a few times now you feel like it's a game where Storm can get out of hand. Do you just have to farm up the Blink? Do you look for a smoke gank to get the Shadow Shaman, maybe a tower, and then pressure? What's like the long-term approach here for Secret, given how good Storm could be in this matchup?
I think it's not even just the Storm, it's the SF.
The SF as well.
Yeah, he's almost got a fully completed BKB. He's got a DD on himself and burning. It's like you said, it's not even the fact that it was meant to go mid. It's just, it was easy for him to do. He rotates between the jungle and mid. But Secret, I think they have to go for the Roche here. They have to make use of the wards. I was going to say that before I interrupted myself. Because you can't go for the tower at bottom
anymore. Only you could interrupt yourself.
You can't go for the tower at bottom anymore because IG, they'll TP for it every single time. Like, they can feel that the type of lead that they have, so you have to start going for the safer objectives, and this is a really good one for them to go for because IG, after
Ice
this...
Ice Blast is coming in. It's going to connect on two, maybe three. Ortiz, he gets bashed as well in the pit. The stun's coming. Another rocket piles into him, and the hook! Lua looking to turn it, and now the jump forward, the Aegis Snatch! 430, got it! He's done it, but can he live round two? They've got Alina's stun in 3 seconds. It's not quite soon enough. Yules setting up, buying time. Stun is there. Maybe they can kill him twice. It's a track kill if they do it. Yes, they will.
Oh, Secret might get isolated too.
Bernie runs in, but it's without the BKB. He does pop the mech. He tries to run, but he's a man on his own. Requiem, not in time. Secret pull out the magic. And they hang on despite what looked like imminent disaster. The Aegis Snatch, they did get the last hit. But they kill him twice.
That's perfectly fine for Secret. They got the
That's
last
beyond
hit on...
perfectly yeah, fine.
They got the last hit on the Roshan.
Oh, close call.
They got the last hit on the Roshan. They killed two of the cores. I didn't even see how they were going to kill Burning in the first place. They get him before the BKB comes out. Unfortunately, Arteezy does die, but in Secret, once again, this is a game that they can definitely still win, and this puts them in control of both XP and net worth, and we finally saw that Bounty Hunter pay off. So many track kills in that fight.
I'm not sure if Secret realized it, but Burning was 100 gold or so, maybe 150 to 200 away from BKB. Imagine if he walks in there with a BKB. They have no counterplay right now. They don't have the Lina eggs. Their physical damage is, it's good for Arteezy, but it's not that great for a single target. But they found the timing. Secret, they did lose a tower top while that was going on, but absolutely worth it. And Storm, no Aegis to play with. Once he respawns and dies again, Arteezy is on the run here. Can Luo hit a miracle hookshot? Currently, no vision, and he's being scouted out. Looks like Arteezy's going to stick around, but won't get caught.
The thing about that play, though, is if everybody from IG rotates in, Secret can just lose the game right there.
Yeah.
If anybody backs up that Storm Spirit,
that's such a risk.
The game is pretty much over, but that's what you have to do to win an international. You've got to take risks.
They will find a haste rune top now. Two heroes moving in, also scouted. Five could converge. Arteezy has Eclipse, and he's going to go with it just for Tuan, who fogs them and tries to turn this around. He will get cornered. That Luna just a bit too nimble in the night. And now the follow-up coming for Luo, who's completely chain stunned. Five hero track kill. Secret erupting here in the decisive game number three. They extend their advantage to 7,500, what was once dead even in gold, or only a 2,000, 1,500 lead, and experience actually going IG's way has really opened up. The Ice Blast will come in, but it's not enough to deter the push.
Why do we ever forget about track kill? Like, there's a reason Bounty Hunter keeps getting picked up.
I mentioned it.
It's so hard to fight against that hero because you have to take reliably safe fights. But in Dota, there's no such thing as a reliably safe fight. And every single time you give up one or two heroes, you think, okay, it's only a support, but it's a five-man track kill. You have to wonder about that every single time, and it's got to be at the back of your mind. And they know that Ferrari's here, and they might actually isolate him out.
They have the blink. The blink is
looking
online
for this right now.
It's not on Puppy, though, so he won't have it to initiate this one, unfortunately. But they are going to look for Faith. Easy takedown for S4. The track, they wait, and they get it. Three hero Ice Blast comes out, but absolutely no follow-up. Clockwork moving into position here. We'll have the hook, but it's going to be after the Ice Blast wears off. They really need a counter kill. IG need this one. They're going to find S4. There's the hook. He's trapped within the cogs. Yule's cooling down in four. They need some backup. Laguna turns it. Death Ward as well, and they can't get the job done. But the cask is a bouncing, and Chuan almost finishes off two. He actually fails to get any. He's been left alone. Where's the backup for Chuan? He's just not getting it. This could be another track kill again. And meanwhile, on the mid, where Zai is holding on against 430, even backs him back in. Jumps in once more. TP. Can he cancel? And they got him! IG self-destructing, and Secret taking every opportunity to pull ahead. Bernie will mech him up. I mean, maybe 430 gets out with his life, but if so, only barely. Kuro gives the track. So they have the move speed. They can search Kuro in. They're going to go for this. They're committing for something extra. Bernie does BKB Requiem. He might need to use a track. Self-deny does come out. The Requiem onto Kuro. No, he's just going to TP out instead. won't even bother. Burning, so afraid of forfeiting additional track gold. This game is out of hand, Blitz. It's only 14-8 in terms of kills, but when you look at objectives here and when you look at just the graphs, it is an ugly, ugly sight.
It's just the momentum right now. This Shadow Fiend already pops his 10-second BKB. I can't even explain to you how crucial that is in these team fights when you're going up against a team that has multiple stuns and disables. IG don't have the best comeback mechanic. You're relying a lot on Ferrari being able to build up Bloodstone charges, but he had to use the suicide there. And all the while, Secret are getting these individual pickoffs that lead to track kills over and over again, and IG are just being thwarted every single time.
Can somebody let Puppy get his Blink Dagger here? He had it in the fight bottom. It's 23 minutes in. He's got another 1,300 gold. I mean, normally the life of a support is suffering, but this is an unnecessary breed of it. He should have it soon. Coming is the BKB, though, on Arteezy. And with that, you have the Ice Blast, you have the Death Ward, you have some answers to BKB Blitz, but they don't have the best physical damage here. Only Burning Shadow Fiend, and it feels like every fight he's just been caught out.
Secret right now, they just have to play safe. Arteezy's getting his BKB delivered.
Oh, they see one. They see one. They're surging. They're looking for Burning. He needs to BKB dodge this stun or he's going to go down. He will immediately. Luo with the counter initiation raises. Death Ward commitment. Arteezy walks into it. He turns onto Luo. The back wall the other way from Zai. Looking for the backstep. Requiem will mitigate some of this outgoing damage from Arteezy. And now they barge forward
BKB's
with Arteezy.
Out.
This is a big kill if they can grab it. Bloodstone charges coming. The war trap of Puppy. But he's going in one at a time. He needs the help of the team. And now 430 looking for more, nobody else to claim. Fortunately, IG don't have track gold for Secret, but the push has stopped. The first BKB charge used up. IG with a nice hold, and this game gets tenser. That was surprisingly big. 3,400 gold swing going IG's way. Still a sizable lead for Secret, but momentum slipping away a bit there.
Part of the problem with initiating on Burning there is that the thought process is, okay, I'll use them up, he'll use his BKB, and then we waste a BKB charge, we can disengage, but it's Alina. She's got no HP, no armor. She's now gotten rid of her defensive mechanism. The clockwork hooks in. There's actually nothing you can do to save him at that point.
And if she just throws out the Yules and then backs off, he doesn't have to BKB.
Exactly.
Because he'll see that she's not going for him. So, bit risky there for Secret. Tried to go in for the backstab, but didn't really find a super Eclipse Vacuum combo, and ultimately, they'll slow them down a bit. Still, new items are coming out. The hood is picked up here. Secret, I believe somebody told me yesterday, was the only team to build a pipe, at least through the group stage. It's not been a very common item, but Kuro has done it on Bounty Hunter before, and it looks like he may do it again here with the hood. Could mitigate a lot of this magic damage from the Ancient Apparition, from the Storm, and even the Shadow Fiend to this point is still mostly a nuker.
It's so big against the Ancient Apparition right now. It means that, I mean, Secret, once they get hit by it, no mech's going to come in, and you need some way to mitigate some damage because IG are going to full-on commit once the Ice Blast hits. You saw it right there when S4 got immediately blown up. They need some sort of defensive item for him. I actually think a Force Staff on one of their heroes would be so crucial at this point in the game. Like, you need to get S4 out of there. He's one of your primary initiators with that Yule Scepter, but at the same time, once he commits it, dead every time.
Oh my god, he's already got the pipe. And I think more importantly for Secret, this is about to be a level 2 track. You get that 5 hero kill on a single hero on their own, all of a sudden that's 400 gold for your allies, 275 for yourself, 675 gold plus the gold that you get for the actual kill. That's like a 1k gold swing practically for every single kill. Gotta be careful now if you're IG. They have not seen this pipe just yet. The Lina Ag's also complete. It looks like Secret about to hit a new timing window this game on the side of IG. We did see 430 get the Bloodstone. We see Burning progress now. What do you expect as the next big items to come out for IG?
I think Burning gets something like a Butterfly or just raw HP. Once he sees that Aghanim's Lina, I think even a Scotty is pretty worth it. For the Storm Spirit, you need some sort of disable to when you run in. I don't know if Orchid is worth it anymore at this point in the game. Probably something like a Lincoln's or a BKB. A defensive item would be really good for him here, especially against the Shadow Shaman. Like, that would render pretty much all of Secret's disables useless, and it would allow him to use his full maniple without any fear of them being able to stun him up and kill him. But Secret, they need to get some control again. That mid-fight was pretty disastrous for them, and it's going to be in the form of a 4-man smoke gank, and Kuro is level 11 now.
Their team fight is so much stronger. It feels like this is a big timing for Secret. Even the Guardian Greaves up on Zai. One important tool that IG now have is the level 2 Ancient Apparitional. With this, It's a lot of extra damage, and maybe Faith, we'll have to see. Does he want the Midas here? Does he go straight into an Aghanim Scepter? It's pretty late for a Midas. But he's hanging onto his gold for now. Could have bought the point booster.
Oh,
and now they're looking.
Up.
430. He's the gem carrier. The smoke not breaking it, but they are getting nervous. They begin to back off. Zai already used his blink offensively. His smoke breaks and everybody scatters, burning to the south. The rest to the north. Faith about to be caught out here. Looks like they may lose the Ancient Apparition. Or is that Hex just out of range? He's going to go for the TP, but S4 can easily stun him. Drops the Ice Blast, knows his fate is death. And they get the four hero track takedown. That's a lot. That's a lot of gold. Normally you'd say no big deal, but when there's a bounty hunter, it is a big deal.
Every single time they do that, it's well worth it for them. But
1,300 gold swing just for that.
Fantastic.
Jeez.
What do you even say about that? Bounty hunter, what a hero.
It really is. And it also means there's no Ice Blast right now, and this gives Secret a bit more confidence. They're going to deploy also level 2 wards. The analyst talked about the potential core Shadow Shaman eggs, but it seems a support one maybe in the making. IG are prepping, though. Looks like they want to have a crack at this Rosh once again. They move into position. The Ice Blast might get here just in time. The Bash comes on Arteezy, slowing down this Roshan attempt. Do they go? If they want to, it's right now, but with the pipe activated, they really don't have much firepower against it. And Secret, this time, it's a free Aegis. IG forced again into the back foot, and they move on to mid. No wards, but a lot of items and a very strong five-man coming their way.
Arteezy's level 16. S4's also almost level 16. He's got the Aghanim Scepter. The pipe is on cooldown, but they still have a lot to work with, and that tower is a little bit too low for IG to want to fight, and IG's just trying to play the split push game. The Storm's just trying to farm for his life. What you do as a Storm in this situation, you play for that one big fight. You don't really care about these individual pickoffs anymore. You're just trying to increase your net worth as much as possible. So when that one big fight comes, you walk away with 10 Bloodstone charges or something and you win.
Well, there'll need to be some buybacks here at Secret for him to get that from one fight.
10 total, LD. 10 total.
Okay.
I know there's only 5 heroes, man.
You too can math. The hook finds one. It's onto Arteezy, but he's got an Eclipse available. Doesn't want to blow it off the battle. BKB tries to fight this. Lucent Beam still holding the Eclipse. He's thinking about it. He even started to cast it, but ends up not. Track coming in now. Are they going to go for the Requiem on the respawn? Is the timing right? Yes, it is! They get Arteezy! What a pick! The timing for Burning! They're looking for more of the jump. This could be the one big fight. Track going out the other way. The Death Ward zoning them with the back. The wall! The counterplay from Zai! He is the difference for Secret, and now they on 430. He has the gem. He's got the gem. Even if he Bloodstone denies, it's a gem down. And Secret will snag it. And even after what looks like an amazing pick, they're going to lose more. They may even lose Chuan Zai. No mana for a Vac here. He'll settle for a Sentry Ward. Again the gold. It just keeps on piling in for Secret, who grieves up. They have wards, and they're pinging out bottoms. Zai's going to swing around, dewarding everything. So even if he loses this gem, they've established some map control once more. And plop go the wards. IG, none of their big team fight heroes available, aside from Luo. They do know Arteezy's missing, and they're going for it. They go onto the wards, but instant yules. Perfect counter initiation. He's got the blade mail up. Don't want to Laguna that. And it's actually still cooling down for 5 seconds. They'll glimmer Luo back, but with the hook down, it allows Secret a safe retreat. Wards will be farmed up here. It's not going to be an Axe or a Midas for Faith Blitz, though. He goes very defensive. He picks up a Glimmer Cape. I will say this is very common for Faith. A lot of other support Ancient Apparitions, we'll see them really prioritize getting the fast Axe, being more of a big damage dealer in team fights, but Faith plays more of a hard support AA, and it's going to be Chuan who's the one going for an Axe. He's got two of the components so far.
I think they just need the damage from the Death Ward in these fights. They don't really have the best physical damage, especially with their Storm Spirit getting a BKB.
And then there's a pipe for the magic.
Exactly, and something I just want to highlight there, Zai was so patient, and IG, you could see their entire team pinging. They were just getting emboldened. They're like, we got this fight, Arteezy's dead, we even killed the Aegis, there's no way they can fight us anymore. They jump on a S4, he's kept alive by that pipe for so long. I mean, IG set that fight up perfectly. Chuan was on the high ground. He's dropping his Death Ward. IG stack on top of him. Zai with the perfect initiation. You couldn't have scripted that better. And S4 delivers with that stun.
Uh-oh, 430. He's been a little bit overzealous here. But get caught by the stun. He tried to zip out. Now he's out of mana. Laguna ends him. No track gold, I suppose. But that's a small consolation here for IG. An avoidable kill. That's a mistake that could come back to haunt him. 1,000 gold swing again, and an Arteezy pushing in solo bottom. Oh, he's up far. Luo is fishing for the hook. Not gonna find it.
That's a 2 Bloodstone charge Storm Spray now. It's not even worth... If you're going for the high ground defense, you have like 6 Bloodstone charges, you win a fight, you're suddenly up to 10. That means in one other fight, you can boost it up to 15 and almost instantly revive. But with 2 in the game, you just don't really do anything anymore.
Faith will glimmer away. I was being pursued a bit by Zai, but they were waiting on the S4 ultimate to cool down. Almost ready. He's picked up another Ogre Club. Looks like BKB will be his choice as well. And it feels like a lot of this game is just going to rely on burning at this point, with the Storm struggling to get involved. He has gone Ultimate Orb. Probable Eye of Skadi to come out. Is this a game where Shadow Fiend can carry it Blitz, or are they relying here on the Storm to catch up?
The Storm has to catch up. The problem is that he still doesn't have his BKB. It's 33 minutes in, and he doesn't have a damage item to go with it. And this Bloodstone, if it was at neutral charges, at 8, he'd be fine, but at this phase of the game, when he only has 2 charges left in his stash, that's 1 more death, you're at 1, and then from there, it's just kind of pitiful. Like, you can't really afford to die anymore at all in these fights. Like, you have to live throughout them. But I don't even know if he can. Even with the BKB, his damage just isn't there. Like,
and they have a lot of BKB piercing damage. The wards, the physical damage of Arteezy, now up to 210 plus a pop. I mean, everyone hits pretty hard here, courtesy of that Luna Aura. And of course, you've got the pure damage of the Aghanim Scepter. It's 950 compared to... It's half his health, basically. He's sitting at 1800. I mean, the BKB, it helps a bit, but... It feels like he has to bait the team. He really has to let somebody else go in first, and that's where Chuan is kind of the secret weapon for IG. They've given him farm priority over Faith's Ancient Apparition. He is closing in on Ags. Maybe a big death ward can be the difference maker. But they're running out of time, IGR. Their last outer tower now finished off. The map is starting to look very green. Not what the IG fans want to see here. A secret move around the Rosh Pit. Still a couple minutes before he can respawn.
Arteezy just farming out the Ancients. He's going to go back. They're just disengaging right now, but IG, they just have to power farm as much as they possibly can before the next fight. Ferrari now has his BKB, so he's going to feel a little bit more comfortable pushing in. And if you're smart, you'll never get hit by anything from Secret. Like, there is a Blink Dagger on Puppy, but it's that Aghanim Scepter that I'm more worried about. Like, Puppy in the first game, if you remember, buys the double bottle, has absolutely nothing in the late game. In the last 2 games, he's saying, okay, none of that anymore. I'm tired of doing that for you guys. I'm a part of this game, too.
I deserve farm as well.
He really does. I mean, he makes it work.
He does. He's made plays for the team. And the thing is, with the nature of their draft, they've gone, and the items they built, they've gone very 5-man heavy. The pipe, the Guardian Greaves, the ward upgrade from the Ags. This team, if you have 1 bad fight, will Rax you. Like, it's going to happen. And they're almost level 3 wards as well. Secret, this could be the death blow for IG. They've got to be careful not to get caught out, and down in the wrong position right now is Burning. The area is being pinged out. I don't think they've actually scouted him directly with ward vision, but now they see the H is being farmed. They know he's up the hill. Are they just going to go for it blind? Luo's behind him. Does he hook to disengage? No, it's Luo who gets caught. He immediately, the wards plop down, and well, that's a dead clock, but do they push on? They've bought time for Chuan. He has managed to farm up the Ags. But there's no clockwork to screen and protect this.
I mean, I think if you're Secret, you don't go for the push right now. Ideally, you want to wait for at least one of 2 things. Either you get another pickoff and you still have your wards available, or you get the Aegis. Like, there's no way after dropping those wards, you want to continue to go for the push. Split out the map, buy yourself some more time. Don't hard commit to anything. If you notice right now, they're just splitting up on the map, because if they do get caught out, they're saying to themselves, okay, we'll lose 1 or 2 heroes. That's okay. They can't go for a further push from that. Maybe to get the Aegis, but we can start defending that area as well.
They are farming the enemy Ancients here, and the ward advantage continues to go their way. This goes back to the death of 430 Storm earlier, where they gifted a free gem to Secret. The map control has gone so much for the Radiant now that IG, it feels a lot more like, I mean, a lot like game 1, to be honest, Blitz, where it was just all Secret all the way. This game a bit slower for them to get the advantage, but they have bottled IG up, and IG are having none of it. They're going to make their move out towards mid. They show Burning in the lane. Kuroki down in the river, almost the perfect location to just break the smoke and get out safely. He is going to walk up the hill. The pings come out, so they commit. They drop a sentry. He's out of range, and it feels dangerous to walk down here. Not worth it for a bounty. Not worth it at all, say IG. But that is a smoke blown. They've got none in stock for 4.5 minutes, none on the heroes and none on the courier, so this just made the potential Roche fight a whole lot trickier.
And you have no idea how significant that is. When you don't have a smoke for 4 minutes and you know that Roshan's coming up, it's so hard to fight that because Secret are just going to have the superior vision. They've got the gem, they've got more availability on the map, they've got, I think they have a smoke of their own on somebody, but when you don't have a smoke like that and you just go in, it's
there's
for the
hug. We're starting the fight off. They found Kuro off the bat. That limits the amount of track hold that will come up. Aluo, the first man down. Now the Requiem trying to turn this fight. Follow up by his blast. A huge amount of damage. And the Death Ward rains down. But S4 scurries away. They haven't finished up anyone crucial here. Just a bounty hunter. And Puppy turns it. He traps in Burning inside the wards. Holds him in position. They don't have a Laguna, but they have the chain stun. Burning in jeopardy. Burning down. Four have fallen. Outmaneuvered. Outfought. And out. Played IG about to get wiped. Chuan, the last man standing, he just didn't quite find the ward position. It's five dead, and it's straight down the middle lane. Forget about the potential Roche secret save. We want Rax, and we want them right now.
And you just saw, I mean, they didn't have a smoke, they don't really have vision right there. And Secret just outvisioned them, outplayed them. Puppy, with that individual play, pretty much neutralizing Burning. Everybody from Secret converging with almost no HP. Just a complete outplay, and IG just get outmaneuvered around the map, and I don't know if they can survive that next net worth swing.
Their only saving grace, and I really mean only, was that Bounty Hunter died early, else Kuroki may have gotten 3-4 tracks off. He got the one on Luo, but that small consolation, they still swing the Grath even further their way, and it sets up for a very secret favored Roche fight. What do IG do? They don't have the smokes available. One's going to cool down in 2.5 minutes, but it feels just so risky to go on the offense at this stage.
Oh, and
Luo, he's hooking in. They're committing for this. The Ice Blast's off the mark, though. It's going to be a dead clock, nothing gained, and a track, a five-hero track. It just really can't get any harder for IG than this. It really can't.
I think that was just pure frustration. You don't have any vision up there. You have to know that Secret are going to five-man because they want to go for that next Roche, and he still makes that attempt. And this is going to mean a free Roche for certain.
They have no clock. If they go into the pit and don't steal the Aegis and they die, that's pretty much the game. And even if they grab it, we saw what happened last time. They are moving Chuan slightly into position. There's already a sentry and a ward, a whole array of wards here for Secret,
for
marking that they control this pit, but he is prepping for a potential jump in. At least with Nuff, they're going to think better. But everybody retreats. They sacrifice the Aegis, now eclipsing a 25,000 gold lead, far more than what Secret had in game one when they ended up losing, and feeling just in command of this game in every aspect. Farm, team fight, levels, map control, extra lives. They have every tool to win.
They finally have really reliable high ground too. You can just set the wards up there, set the Luna with Aegis up as well. You've got a cheese on your heroes. You've got tons of counter initiation, and IG can't afford to take another poor fight. I mean, poor Ferrari just at one Bloodstone charge. I don't even know what happens if you have zero. Can you still deny? What does that do for you?
You damage your team. You start hurting them, sucking their HP away.
He just needs damage right now, but IG, they've got one attempt at this, and you've got to dominate this fight too.
There's a glyph. They're going to use it now, but do they really want to commit on Arteezy? Everybody else so far back, only two heroes in front. Now the tracks start coming out, trying to bait out a BKB, just something, but Burning takes heavy damage. Another Lucian Beam. They keep on spamming him. Now the glaives begin to bounce. This makes life hard for the supports. Out goes the pipe. Secret zeroing in on their first lane of Brax and salvaging their TI run if they could just take this game and make it their own, and they get the first lane of Brax. They do it cleanly. Is IG even gonna put up a fight? They decide not this lane. We're gonna have to wait for the next. But at that point, if they don't hold, if they don't even try Blitz, it's almost impossible.
The thing is, Secret can just wait for the next set of wards LD before they go in. They'll still have the Aegis by the time it's up. I think IG's thinking was a little bit off. They were like, okay, we can give up this Rax. The wards are laid out, they've got an Aegis, there's no way that we can fight, but Secret can just do the exact same thing to you at the bottom lane. They've got enough time on this Aegis to do that. And I think Secret, especially after that, what just happened right there, they're going to feel so strong going into this next fight, but IG, they just continue to lose out on net worth. That's 30k now after that set of racks is taken, and it's starting to approach the territory where it doesn't even matter if you win the next
four
fights.
You can just A, at some point, you're so farmed, you can just A-click the enemy fountain and you'll probably win the fight. Maybe press R along the way. And Secret are getting there. If IG could turn this, this, I believe, would statistically be the biggest comeback in TI history.
Puppy's just waiting for his wards to refresh. 30 seconds away. IG, I mean, you give up that mid-rax, but the exact same thing's going to happen to your bottom one.
And there's just no, there's no pressure. In the anti-mage game, the lanes were being pushed out by Burning. Secret struggled to gank him. Arteezy will pick up yet another big item. So difficult to bring down now. 2,700 health and tons of armor, and the physical damage is mediocre. Burning with only a Crystallis to call his own. And now they go. Pipe immediately. Raise number one comes down in the jump in for 430. He BKBs immediately. They want to kill a Puppy, but he's already dropped the wards. So what does it really matter? Requiem was there, but Arteezy fights his way through it. And now can go in with the Eclipse. The creep's there to tank it, but continues to rain down Golden Doom upon IG. Burning's done for. He has the buyback, but everybody from Secret stands together. They lost as a team, and now they're winning as one. And they go for the throne. They hang on here at TI. One of the fan favorites coming in, about to end it. Tier 4s fall, and your TI 2 champions, they just don't have much left. One last hold, that's all it is. A few moments, and then IG will tap out, and we'll see 430 and Faith denied a chance to repeat. S4 and Puppy, they'll have theirs, as 430 is the last man down. This one hurts, Blitz, and it feels so good for Secret.
But they still have to be sweating. This game was a little bit more close for comfort in that mid-game, and, I mean, all the way down game one, take the next two. I mean, you gotta be sweating.
Only one team can move on, and that makes Secret the last team to move into the top eight here at TI, but they've got a long and tough road ahead of them. They show that they can do it.